St. Peter would pay 3,000. However, there are some municipalities that assess consultant fees, often in areas that need improved wireless service the most, that can range upwards of $15,000 to $20,000. These numbers are high enough to prevent T-Mobile and likely other carriers from being able to build in those areas. In addition, because the resources at wireless companies are finite, when we must spend exceptionally high amounts of money to build in one area, we do not have the resources to build out in other areas. Your neighbors to the south recognized this a few years ago and did something about it. In 2013, Missouri passed legislation much like what we're discussing here today. And in 2015, Iowa did the same. Our proposed legislation would limit third-party consultant fees to something that is reasonable and affordable, enabling wireless carriers to continue investing all over Minnesota. It is important to understand that this will not prevent jurisdictions from utilizing third-party consultants. We understand that many communities do not have the resources or expertise to evaluate wireless applications, and many consultants help to streamline these processes. However, some consultants add unnecessary assessments to an application, causing the fees that are passed on to the wireless carriers to skyrocket. In some examples, we've had cases where 12 different people were not professional engineers, reviewed plans, reviewed drawings. Dozens of hours were billed for computer time, travel expenses, and multiple sidewalks, and they continued to bill long after the site was actually completed. It should be noted that the proposed legislation does not affect the small cell language that was passed last year. What Senate File 3166 would simply do is limit application fees to install or replace wireless facilities on new or existing structures to $3,000. That is all that it does. Minnesota deserves to have the best technology available and quality, high-speed, broadband wireless coverage throughout the state. This legislation will encourage wireless investment, promote economic growth, and prepare your communities for the next wave of wireless technology. Wireless customers in Minnesota, your constituents, are demanding high-speed wireless broadband technology. Now is the time to ensure that their needs are met. I thank you for your time, and I hope that you will consider Senate File 3166.
Thank you. That is the only testifiers we have in support of this. I'll ask the General Shrug if you have a little less than 9 minutes left. Is there anyone in the room that would like to speak in support of Senate File 3166? Seeing none, we will move to the opponents of the bill. Thank you, gentlemen. We'll move to the opponents of the bill. First one, as I stated before, Stephen Huser is first. That was the first contact that we made, and we are taking them in order. Please state your name for the record and begin your testimony.
Thank you, Mr. Chair and members of the committee. My name is Steve Huser, and I represent Metro Cities. Metro Cities represents the shared interests of cities in the 7 County metro area. Metro Cities respectfully opposes Senate File 3166, a bill that would place a cap on wireless facility application fees. This bill contradicts Metro Cities' policy supporting local authority by allowing municipalities to determine local fees that meet the actual cost of city work. Metro Cities is concerned that a cap on these fees will create a situation where a municipality will not be able to recover the cost incurred for processing applications. This could have the effect of local property taxpayers subsidizing the wireless industry. Thank you for your consideration.
Thank you. Next on the list is Laura Ziegler. And behind that is Deborah Heiser. Ms. Ziegler, state your name for the record. Begin your testimony.
Thank you, Mr. Chair, members of the committee. I'm Laura Ziegler, representing the League of Minnesota Cities, a statewide organization representing over 830 cities across the state. And the committee may recall that there were substantial conversations last year about wireless technology in this committee, and that ended with significant changes to telecom law passed last session. There was an understanding and expectation among stakeholders in the interim that there would not be legislation pushed for this year in the wireless arena. And so I'd like to thank the author and the chair for having this bill heard on an informational basis only today. As introduced, we are opposed to Senate File 3166. We believe that cities should be able to collect the costs necessary to ensure that there will be no damage done to our infrastructure or risk to the public. While we can appreciate appreciate that the company supporting this bill is not questioning city's ability to use third-party contractors, which in this case are the engineering firms that have been mentioned. This bill does demonstrate a significant shift by a single wireless carrier to place the burden of paying for their infrastructure on public assets to the city, should that $3,000 cap be exceeded. It's an interesting bill in that the company's issue isn't technically with the city, but rather the private firms that work on behalf of the city. And I do have Deborah Heiser here on behalf of the city engineers to provide a little bit of additional context for you, and more information, of course, will be here for questions. So thank you, Mr. Chair.
Ms. Heiser, state your name for the record. Give me your testimony.
Mr. Chair, members of the committee, my name is Deb Heiser. I'm the engineering director of the city of St. Louis Park. As mentioned before, cities can provide engineering services in one of two ways. A lot of cities have consultants as an engineering firm, and they provide all of the engineering services. Larger cities, and unfortunately, have this staff engineer. Even our city of 48,000 does not have a structural engineer. When it comes to these types of applications, you need to hire a firm. It's a very specialized area. So, bottom line is the majority of the cities rely on those firms. And they are local firms, they're local employees, and people live in my city. I've got a lot of consulting engineers in my city, work for the city's WSB, and the road of consultants. These services are necessary to provide that review for those master sites and applications. When a business works for a client, they get lost. And a lot of times, that means that there's $3,000 or $1,000, whatever the case may be, to get the job done. There's no one size fits all when it comes to these water towers. There's different ages. You see all the different styles of water towers that are out there. There's different ages, there's different antennas that are being applied to, different types of joints and wells and holes. What it comes down to is the structural reference is proposed, you're even designing easily to get that.
General statement, people, please put your cell phones on mute and have your phones if you're going to be listening to people giggle in the crowd. So we want to be respectful to our time and keep things moving. We do have additional, before I go to Senator Hall, we do have 8.5 minutes left. Is there anyone else in the crowd that would like to speak against this bill? Seeing none, one other clarification, this bill is not being included in the honors bill, it is being laid over, it is informational only, but we are not moving this into an honor business, this is the only stop it's going to have, so we
Thank you, Senator Hall. I missed it. I apologize. I was distracted a little bit. Where does the $3,000 figure come from?
Senator Hall.
I'll let my answer that.
Mr. Chairman, Senator Dibble, we reviewed a large volume of applications that were processed through the city across the state of Minnesota. That is on behalf of T-Mobile, whose client I'm representing today. And that was our best estimate as to what we saw as an average fee that we thought reflected the vast majority of cities, frankly. And admittedly, as the testimony indicates, there are some outliers to that, which is really the source of concern.
Senator Dibble?
So, Mr. Chair, with the outliers, then perhaps be in violation of language that's would the outliers violate language if this were to be passed that would say limit an application fee to the actual cost incurred? I mean, are these outliers, are cities charging more than they should? Are they trying to make money from these fees?
That's a great question. That's a great question, Senator, Mr. Chairman, Senator Dibble. What we see when we process these applications is that in some communities, not all, but in some, the local jurisdiction assigns a billing rate for their staff, and that rate, we don't really know where that comes from, but we assume that's a rate that they develop internally. But what we also pay is the bill that the consultants that the local government engages to represent it. And we have no control, we have no say if they're doing good work or bad work. We don't have any role to play in that. We just have to pay the bill if we want to get a permit. That's the issue.
Senator Dibble.
Thank you. I would probably support this bill up to the point at which language says actual cost incurred, et cetera, putting cost of third party, et cetera. I think where people start hopping around is the $10,000 limitation. I think that's pretty consistent with the limitations that we have in law around amount of fees, state agencies, county governments, local governments can charge for fees provided for services. Of course, you know, the $4,000 or $3,000 question is how do you peg that? I hope you get that. But there are mechanisms to figure that out without the city charging too much. So you got me halfway there.
Any further questions? Senator Marty?
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Is without this bill, our city is allowed to charge, I mean, they can certainly cover their costs of the work. Are they allowed to exceed the actual cost of reviewing the application? In other words, is it that you think some of the cities are just to make money, or if we're hearing from Lakeville and Bloomington and so on, that many times they're spending much more than that for the consultants to come in? Is it concerned that they're making money off of it, and if so, wouldn't you accomplish that just by saying in the law that they can't charge more than the cost of doing it?
Mr. Chairman, Senator Marty, that's also a very good question. That's not the contention that we're making today. We want cities to have good technical consultants. We're concerned that there's no accountability for the bills that they are presenting to us that reflect the work of their consultants or perhaps that of their staff in some cases. That's the primary concern.
Senator Goddard.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Do you have an idea of what the average cost is per city when you go in for these applications? Is it $2,000, $5,000?
Mr. Chairman, Senator Goggin, the application fees, which is one piece of this number that we're talking about, routinely are in the $300 to $500 range in terms of the application fee. But then it's the